look away for you. Team player. I lose the way, I lose the way.
I'm so excited. Finally, after making us wait, which felt like forever, Shekinah has finally dropped her sophomore album, which is called Trouble in Paradise. And she's my guest for my Mac Cafe ride along this morning. I can't wait to hang out with her. Hi, good morning. Please, can I have 2 Mac Cafe coffees? Yes. Thank you. Morning. Mac Cafe coffee. Thank you so much, Izzy. Have an amazing day. Thank you so much for joining me. Thank you so much for joining me. How are you feeling this morning?
Your team's been amazing, so
So you're super chilled?
Super relaxed, and then here we go, right?
Shekinah, so speak to me. I think the last time I spoke to you, I think you were literally maybe 19 or 20.
Mm-hmm. Sure,
and I think you're maybe like 26 now.
Yeah.
Speak to me about the Shekinah that I met back then. I mean, I remember you were excited for people to hear that you could sing,
yes,
that you, Back to the Beach is your song,
yeah,
and that you've actually the superstar, you know. Now you are in the game, and I look at you, I think you're a bit more reserved.
Yeah.
You know, what has changed?
You want it so bad, and then you have it, and then you're like, ugh.
Yeah.
No, don't ask me that. Don't leave me alone. I always tell people that, like, you know, when you come out, you're so hungry, you want people to know that this is who I am, you're trying to prove yourself. And I think, like, not to speak about my music too much, but like,
yeah,
with my first album, I felt like it was very like, hear me,
Rose Gold was very, I'm here.
And then like, Trouble in Paradise is just like, I'm like, almost like, you know, I guess just,
But
too much
pressure. Is there too much pressure now to release music, now that you are in the game and there's an expectation, versus coming in where all you want is just for people to hear? Do you find more pressure now?
Definitely. I don't like it. It's become a job. Before it was like super cool and like fun.
Yeah.
But now it's become a job. So I think I think that's the reason why I take time, is because I just want it to be natural.
Yeah.
I don't want to have to drop music.
Yeah.
Music is therapy. So I want it to be when it's ready to happen, or when you know what you want.
Not like on timelines that now it's time for an album.
Yeah.
And funny enough, obviously you moved from Durban, you came to Joburg, and then you went back. And everyone thinks that Joburg is this big dream, that's where you want to go. I am finding every single person goes back.
Yeah.
Why did you decide to go back to Durban? What is it about Joburg that you thought, this is not it?
Because it was, you know, I tried to stick it out. I was like, no, I'm going to stay. You know, so I was like, no, I'm staying. 2020, I stayed in Joburg.
Yeah.
And then 2021, I was like, do I stay, do I go? And I wasn't finishing my album.
Yeah.
I realized like Joburg was just too much pressure.
Yeah.
And I thought that maybe if I move home and I get to see my family more and I relax more and I chill out more.
Yeah.
It'll come back. Yeah,
it
will come back. The love will come back to me. And funny enough, it did. And now I feel like, I feel great because I live this life. I mean, it's only been 3 months, but I know that I'm coming to Joburg to do things.
Yeah.
I'm not coming here to misbehave
or to
feel pressurized. And then I'm going home tomorrow. I'm going to chill at the beach with my girls. And
yeah.
And then I'm coming back next week for a shoot.
For work. So you feel like you're working.
Yeah.
And then speak to me about Trouble in Paradise, because obviously from my thoughts around the fact that it's about dating and all that just going through Trouble in Paradise, explain the title, why that particular title, Trouble in Paradise, and what does it mean?
Okay, so Trouble in Paradise, Joburg was paradise, and everything was rose gold in Joburg.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, Joburg wasn't a cool place for me to be anymore.
Anymore, yeah.
I felt like there was just, like I just, you know, like in the Fixate video, there's a lot of fire and all that stuff. And it felt like I'd burnt bridges. Friends that were friends in first year are not friends anymore.
With that, right? Why does it happen? Do you think they come to you with an expectation that you are going to change or that you shouldn't change and maybe you should? Why do you think the friends, I guess, break up? Or you just think it's growth, it's supposed to happen?
It's growth. It's so sad, but it's like, you know, as much as I heard this morning, but essentially, like, as much as, you know, when something comes into your life,
yeah,
and it brings a problem, there's something in the problem that grew you. So yes. I feel like although we're not friends anymore, me and my best friend are not friends anymore, me and my ex are not, you know, boyfriend
or girlfriend. Or even talking from wanting to be together forever.
Yay!
Do you ever look at, guys, what the hell was I thinking?
I don't say what the hell was I thinking. I'm just saying that, like, it's crazy life, like, can really, you don't know.
You don't know what's going to happen next.
Yeah, I don't say, like, oh my God. Maybe I say that about a few exes. I'm like, thank God
that this didn't.
Yeah, but I think with people, it's like, you're in my life for a reason.
Yeah.
It was a blessing when you were here. And now that you're gone, there's growth and there's change, you know, so... Travel in Paradise is really just about that. I know it comes across as like, yo, I'm just about this brother. But it's really
it's
not.
Bigger than
it's
that,
bigger
yeah.
than that, yeah.
I've set fires and then run away. But where I've been doesn't scare me anymore.
I think for me, one of the amazing things that you did was the Rose Fest. I remember I spoke to Kim Jade, who was one of the MCs.
Yes.
And she was just telling me, I mean, I remember I was actually, we did
she
one in Durban.
Lives on this road.
Yes, she also lives around here. You also did one in Durban.
Yes.
And I think I was one of the few males there because of the radio station.
Yes.
Female cast, female
crew. How beautiful
crew.
Is it?
How does the concept like that come about? I'm going right, yeah?
You're going straight. We almost home.
How does that concept come about?
So, it was doing shows for so long in the country and realizing that 80% of our lineup consisted of males.
Yeah.
And just realizing that there's a gap in the market for all women shows.
Yeah.
Just like how you go to a concert and it's just brothers.
Yeah.
You know, on stage. So I keep saying the same thing, like it's verbatim. So if you've watched another interview, I'm sorry. But like, we're not trying to reinvent the wheel. We're just trying to add like,
a different perspective,
so Rose Fest is that. It's just if the audience wants to celebrate something that's pro woman, right?
Yeah,
then they have the opportunity to. So that's what Rose Fest is, for women, by women, sound is woman, team is woman. We do have men on our team. I think that is also,
but the
like,
key condition, I mean the key positions generally
100%.
Is do you worry about the future? I know that's such an open question.
I do. I did a show the other day and there was no females inside. And that's in 2021. And the thing is as females, even me at the moment, it's like, I've been working with my bands in college, the same bands in college. So I'm like, it's all boys. And I feel like sometimes it's a bit contradictory to my narrative as a pro woman. Yeah.
Yeah.
But the problem is that
they know you.
They know me, and also they're quick on their feet because they get the opportunity. Because women don't get the opportunity to be in certain positions, they don't learn. So that we're like steps behind.
Oh, I get it.
Just by not being in the space or given the opportunity, because things move so fast.
Yeah.
Like, we have a show
there's
tomorrow.
There's no time.
There's
you
no
already
time.
Need to
exactly.
know.
You need to know.
You
now.
Also want the best right now.
Exactly.
You don't want to compromise your product.
100%. So that's the problem that I'm currently facing.
How are you going to find the balance?
I don't know, because I'm still using an old male team. I love you guys, you know that.
But
I'll go to war for you guys, but sometime I need to stop and allow women to try and fill those roles.
Shekinah, thank you for taking
Thanks
me
for
coffee.
Time. Cheers.
Yeah, thank you so much. I'm inspired. Normally I'm the one with the questions. I feel like you're healing me. Thank you.
Oh, yay!
I'm such a fan and
Thank
we love
you.
What you do.
Thank you, guys.
And I love the consistency and the growth.
Thanks.
And shout out for keeping the Durban flag high.
Thank you.
Now we're looking
shout
international.
Out to you. Yeah, no. We
yeah.
Move.
Phew, thank you.
Thank you.
Great coffee, simple.